हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। सो टुडे आई एम डॉक्टर सरोज होले। आई एम टीचिंग यू स्मिथ ट्रिगर टुडे। दिस इज़ अ पार्ट ऑफ पेपर 2, एनालॉग एंड डिजिटल डिवाइस एप्लीकेशंस, चैप्टर 2। ओके, सो चैप्टर 2 इज़ ओपैम एप्लीकेशन। सो स्मिथ ट्रिगर इज़ वन ऑफ द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ ओपैम। इन द बेसिक कंपैरेटर सर्किट फीडबैक इज नॉट यूज्ड। सो ओपैम इट इज़ यूज्ड इन ओपन लूप मोड। As we know that open loop gain of op-amp is very large, so that due to small noise, voltage can cause triggering of the comparator. So this create problem in an application of comparator like zero crossing detector. Such unwanted noise cause the output to jump between high and low state. So the comparator circuit used to avoid such unwanted triggering is called regenerative or Schmitt trigger, which uses positive feedback. So this circuit is also called inverting Schmitt trigger because input is applied to the inverting input terminal. It produces opposite polarity output. So the output is feedback to the non-inverting input. Okay. So this is a Schmitt trigger circuit. Negative terminal input is given and feedback is to V reference voltage. So when Vin is slightly positive than V reference, the output gets driven into negative saturation and minus V saturation level, and when Vin becomes more negative than minus V reference, output gets driven into positive saturation at plus V sat level. So the output voltage is always plus minus V sat. So the level of voltage where it changes can be controlled by the resistance R1 and R2. Thus V reference can be obtained by using potential divider arrangement, and we may write V reference is equal to V0 upon R1 plus R2 into R2. So plus V set is upon R1 plus R2 into R2 for positive saturation, and minus V reference, it is the equation. So plus V reference is more positive for positive saturation when V0 is equal to plus V set is called as upper threshold voltage, denoted as VUT, and minus V reference is for negative saturation when V0 is equal to minus V set and is called as a lower threshold voltage, denoted as VLT. Okay. So minus V reference is V0 upon R1 plus R2 into R2. So is equal to, this is for negative saturation. So V reference is more positive saturation and V0 is equal to plus V sat, more negative when V0 is equal to minus V sat. Thus equations, both the equations can be written like this. Okay. So the output voltage remains in a given state until the input voltage exceeds the threshold voltage level, either positive or negative. So the transfer characteristic of a Schmitt trigger can be shown in this figure. Okay, this is known as a hysteresis curve. So the graph indicates that once the output changes its state, it remains there indefinitely until the input voltage crosses any of the threshold voltage level. So this is called a hysteresis of a Schmitt trigger. The difference between VUT and VLT is called width of the hysteresis and is denoted as H. So H is equal to VUT minus VLT. Okay, so this is the hysteresis curve. Okay, so input output waveform for Schmitt trigger. Sine wave is the input, square wave is the output. Now we will see the Schmitt trigger eliminates the effect of noise voltage present. So the noise voltage less than the hysteresis H cannot cause triggering. So if the input applied is purely sinusoidal, the input and output waveforms for inverting Schmitt trigger can be shown. Now next application is a function generator. So function generator is a signal source that has the capability of producing different types of waveforms as its output signal. So the most common output waveforms are sine waves. So triangular waves, square waves, sawtooth waves, the frequency of such waveforms may be adjusted from the fraction of a hertz to several hundreds kilohertz. So it can generate all sorts of continuous waveforms like sine, square, triangular, ramp. So the frequency and amplitude are adjustable. So the advantage of a function generator over a sine wave oscillator is its flexibility to create non-sine shapes. Actually, the function generators are very versatile instruments as they are capable of producing a wide variety of waveforms and frequencies. So in fact, each of the waveforms they generate is particularly suitable for different group of applications. Now, what are the important features of sine wave? The function generator are capable of producing variety of repetitive waveform, generally from the list below. So the sine wave, a function generator will normally be able to act as a sine wave generator. So this is a standard waveform that oscillates between two levels with a standard sinusoidal shape. So using the function generator as a sine wave generator is one of the more commonly used applications. Sine waves are widely used in testing applications. Now square wave. Another very widely used waveform is the square wave. It consists of a signal moving directly between high and low levels, used as a square wave generator. So this test instrument provides a very useful source of basic digital waveforms. Now triangular pulse wave. A pulse waveform is another type that can be produced by a function generator. It is effectively the same as square wave, but with the Mach space ratio is very different to 1:1. So this form of waveform is again oftenly used within digital applications. Then triangular wave. This form of signal produced by the function generator linearly moves between a high and low point. So this form of waveform is often generated using an operational amplifier acting as an integrator. So the triangular waveform generator typically also has a square wave output as well. So and it is used as the basis of generating all the waveforms in a function generator test instruments. So the triangular waveform is often used in testing amplifiers. It is far easier to see the distortion and clipping on a triangular waveform than it is on a sine waveform. So these are the basic waveforms that are produced within a function generator test instrument. These waveforms satisfy most of the needs for testing number of atoms. Where specialized waveforms are required, then the arbitrary waveform generator is required. Now sawtooth wave. Again, this is a triangular waveform, but with the rise age of waveform faster or slower than the fall, making a form of shape similar to the sawtooth. So it is generated by the same circuit as the triangular waveform, but with the different rise and fall times created by changing the charge rate for the rise and fall elements of a integrator. Okay, so we will see in next lecture, we will see working and block diagram of a function generator. So today we will stop here.